Good morning to all. Today I am going to discuss about the schedule of saving functions. Okay, saving function schedule. In previous video we discussed about the saving functions, the formula of the saving functions. Now in this video we'll discuss about the how to make the schedule of by using the saving functions. So as you know that the saving functions is what s is equal to minus c bar plus 1 minus b y. This is the formula of saving. Okay, so s is equal to minus c bar plus 1 minus b y. So we have, suppose we have given the income and we have to calculate saving. So just write the questions. Let's take example. Let s is equal to minus 15 plus 1 minus 0.5 y is given. If the questions is given, s is equal to minus 15 plus 1 minus by 1 minus 0.5 y is given. Sometime here minus 15 plus 0.5 y is given. So this is also the same things. You can subtract 1 minus 0.5, you will get the 0.5. If directly is mentioned, then you have to convert into this also, 1 minus 0.5. Okay, so this is the equations given. So s is equal to minus 15 plus 0.5 y. So what we do, we just equate the equations. We have s is equal to minus c bar plus 1 minus b y. Okay, so minus c bar, by cutting the equation, minus c bar is equal to minus 50. So c bar is how much? 50. Okay, minus minus will cancel. Now come to here, 1 minus b is how much? 0.5. so 1 is equal to 0.5 plus b. Here 0.5 is equal to b, 0.5 is equal to b. Okay, so by using the concept, c bar is equal to how much? 15, and b is equal to how much? 0.5. okay, so let's take the income. Income is 0, 10, 20, 30 and 40. Okay, and consumption is how much? Consumption, autonomous consumption is 15, already calculated by equating the equations. That is minus c bar is equal to minus 15, so minus minus cancel. So we will get what? C bar is equal to 15. So c bar is 15, 15, 15 and 15. Okay, and b is what? 0.5, 0.5, 0.5 will already calculate. Okay, 0.5. Now what we have to calculate? We have to calculate the saving functions. So saving functions is equal to what? Minus c bar plus 1 minus b y. Okay, minus c bar plus 1 minus b y. So just calculate it. When y is equal to 0, then s is equal to minus c bar plus b y, 1 minus b y. Okay, so s is equal to minus c bar. Minus c bar is how much? 15 plus 1 minus b. B is how much? 5. And we have to consider y is equal to 0. So just multiply by 0. So s is equal to 15 plus 1 minus 0.5 into 0. So minus 15 plus 0.5 into 0 is how much? 0. So s is equal to minus 15. So when the income is 0, when the income is 0, then saving is how much? Minus 50. Okay, now when the income is 10, when y is equal to 10, so s is equal to minus 15 plus 1 minus 0.5 y. So minus 15 plus 1 minus 0.5 y is how much? 10. So minus 15 plus 0.5, 1 minus 0.5 is 0.5 into 10. So minus 15 plus 0.5 into 10 is how much? 5. So minus 15 plus 10 is how much? Minus 10. Okay, because minus 10 is greater than the plus 10. So minus 15 plus 5 is how much? Minus 10. So you just write here minus 10. Okay, when the income is 20, when y is equal to 20, then s is equal to minus, just directly write 15 plus 0.5y. So minus 15 plus 0.5 into 20. So minus 15 plus 10. So minus 5. Okay? So s is equal to what? Minus 5. When income is equal to 30, so s is equal to minus 15 plus 0.5 into 30. So minus 15 plus 15, that is 0. Okay? Similarly, when y is equal to 40, so s is equal to minus 50 plus 0.5 into 40. So minus 15 plus 0.5 into 40 is almost 20. So that is plus 5. Minus 15 plus 20, that is plus 5. So when the income is 20, when the income is 20, that is minus 5. When income is 30, that is 0, that is 5. I think. When the income is 10, minus 10. When the income is 20, minus 5. When income is 30, that is 0. When income is 40, that is 5. Okay? Now, we can see that the income will increase. When the income is 0, the consumption is what? The minus. That time the consumer consumes the goods. When the income is 0, already discussed, when the income is 0, the autonomous consumption will incur. So that time the savings are negative. Okay, now come to the 0 and then saving start. When the income is start, then saving start positive. So this is what? This is the formula of consumptions, saving functions, how to calculate the saving functions. So by using the formula, we can calculate the saving functions also. So we can see that now in this schedule, if you want to calculate consumptions, so what is the consumption? As you know that y is equal to c plus s, so c is equal to what? C is equal to y minus s. So what will you do? We'll just subtract this 0 to minus 15. So 0 minus minus 15 is how much? 15. And 10 minus minus 10 is how much? 0. You can say 20. And 20 minus minus 5, that is 25. And 30 minus 0, that is 30. And 40 minus 5, that is 35. Okay? So by using the formula of y is equal to c plus s, we can calculate consumptions is equal to y minus c, then we calculate the consumptions also. Okay? Now, this is what? This is the schedule of saving functions. Now come to the graphical solutions of the saving functions. How to plot the graph of the saving functions? Means saving function curve. That is what? X axis, that is y axis, that is 0, and this is what? This is income line. Okay, so as you know that you can see this, when the income is 0, then saving is how much? Minus 15. So saving curve is start from where? Is it start from minus portion. So here the minus 15, minus 10, minus 5 and 0. Okay. So saving is start from negative portions. Okay. Then it will reach the break even point. This point is known as break even point. Break even point. That is what? Here income is equal to saving. Okay. And this is this line is what? This is the break even point. And this portion is what? This portion is known as dissaving. Okay. And this portion is known as saving. This saving is what? Here the saving are positive in number. Here the saving are minus in number. Okay. And here saving is equal to income. All the income is the same. So this is the graph of what? This is the graph of the saving functions. And one thing keep in remember in your mind. The saving functions always start from the negative portions, because when the income of the consumer is zero, then that time the saving will be minus. Okay, so saving start from minus portion will go there, and when the income of the consumer will increase, the saving will also the increase. Okay, so this is the concept of how to calculate saving functions and how to plot the graph of the saving functions curve. Okay, I hope you understood the concept of this saving functions. In your book there are so many questions are there, how to calculate the APC, how to calculate the MPC, and how to derive the consumption functions, how to derive the saving functions, how you are going to use the these functions for calculating the income, consumptions and the savings. So you solve all the questions related to your chapter. If you have any doubt, then you can contact me. Okay, thank you so much.